Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how simple it is to set up any screen that you have, any HDMI screen that you have connected with an Amazon Fire TV stick into a beautiful personalized display that you can use using our Mango Display apps. So the first thing you got to do is install the Mango Display app on your Amazon Fire TV. And I've got it right there, so I'm just going to open that up. And you will get a screen telling you to set it up. You have a display device code, which is unique to this screen. And then you can either set up this Mango display using the iOS, using the Mango Mirror iOS app, or you can use the app.mangomirror.com web app. So if you want to set it up using your Android device or a Mac or any PC, you can actually use that. So for this example, I'm just going to go ahead and set it up. So the first thing I'm going to do is on the screen is add it as a display. And then I'm going to enter the code that I see right there that it asks me, and I'm going to finish. And this should change now to show you basically the first widget that's on there, which is, you know, right now just basically a clock. And from the app, whether it's the iOS app or the web app, you can move things around. So for example, if I want to move the clock to the corner of my screen, to the right corner, I just moved it over there. And as soon as it saves, you're going to see it there. And the coolest thing about these is that you can add the backgrounds that you want. So in this case, I'm going to do background for Unsplash. I'm going to choose night sky options and nature. And do that for now. And so you should see this whole black screen now start displaying beautiful high-resolution images that are available on Splash. So you have different categories that you can choose. In this case, I'm basically choosing the night sky to give you that option. And then I'm gonna go ahead and maybe add calendar with some current events that we have on the demo calendar. I'm going to set it to my left. So there you can see, it shows up over there. You can resize it, the text resizes accordingly. So I'm also gonna add, maybe I'll move the clock a little bit to the corner, and I'm gonna add the weather, which is, so I'm just gonna put in my location here and choose the 24-hour weather, and I've got it in Celsius, because that's what we use here in Canada. And I move my weather out over here. As soon as that saves, there you can see the weather is there. So I got the time, I got weather, I got beautiful background images that keep changing. And that's pretty much it from a setup. And now you can just go, you know, set it the way you want it to. So for example, I'm gonna add quotes in here, just so, you know, it's something cool to have every day when you look at your screen. So along with calendar events, now you can see quotes, which is really what I want to have right here below the, I put my quotes right here. It's beautiful quotes that you can have, and obviously you can change things around, and as you can see, the background keeps changing. You know, I can have multiple screens as well, so I can put a second screen in here that, for example, gives me my news. So I'm just going to choose news, ABC News, done for now. You know, leave the same backgrounds on. And so right now you'll see I've got this set for 10 seconds. You know, as the 10 seconds completes, it's gonna then move over and show you my news. So you can have as many screens as you want on here, you know, displaying different data sets. So there's the news that you can see. And you can change the backgrounds. You know, obviously you can have your own images in there. So if you've got Google photo albums that you want to share, you can have those as the background. If you've got iCloud albums, you can share those too. And that's pretty much it. And you can just leave it on there. Once you got it set up and you're done, you don't have to do anything. You know, events and clock and the weather all get automatically updated. So there's nothing else that you need to do. You're set. And if you are using a Fire TV stick, there may be times, you know, obviously in the night or when you're out of the house where you don't want it to keep running. So the best thing that we found is that, you know, rather than try to use software for it, there's this amazing device, which is basically, you know, a motion sensor outlet, right? So you put this into your outlet and then you plug your HDMI screen, you know, whatever screen that is, your TV or an HDMI monitor that you have, into this outlet here. And you have some settings that you can choose. So, you know, you can say, I want it to, you know, cut off maybe 2 minutes after there is no motion, or 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 20 minutes, so whatever works for you. And just make sure this is in a place where, you know, it would capture, this is your motion sensor right here. So we just want to make sure it's going to capture, you know, motion events. So if you walk into the room, you want it to be able to sense you. And then you have that, and that's pretty much it. You're done. You just leave this running, you leave this plugged in, and you're good to go. The screen will turn off automatically when there's no motion, and it'll turn back automatically when there is. So that's pretty much it. So you can have, you know, I'm going to change this back because, you know, I have a lot of text there. I'm going to just leave this at night skies, which is, you know, the best things. And you get beautiful backgrounds there, updated automatically. So that's, there you go. This is exactly what you want to do. In the world of screens now, where these screens are getting cheaper by the day, you can use these anywhere you want in your house, whether it's the kitchen, the bathroom, the bedroom, your living room, to display your all of your photos, anything. Just get a screen, get an app, Amazon Fire TV Stick, and you follow the steps I've shown you here. Either use your iOS device or your web app. If you use your iOS device, you can also add, you know, things like Apple Health, so your steps, your sleep, your heart rate, all that stuff can be displayed. So we're finally here in the future where you can have the screen automatically sense that you're in the room, display your data with amazing images and content that you need to start or end your day. Thank you.